Alright guys, how's everybody doing? Michigan is over. Just want to say it was a great race today. I thought it was a challenging with the there at the end, everybody's got to save fuel and stuff like that. But let's go back to the beginning of the race. I was watching a friend of mine, Rusty, his video, and he's right, it was a good race today. You had, you had a lot of good passing. You had different strategies being played, whether or not you wanted to get points or win the stage. And that's typically what killed Truex and Busch, was they tried to get points for stage two and they never could catch up. They probably had a, if not fast enough cars, Harvick. I was pissed whenever Truex didn't pit there, and Cole Pern said, hey, let's go get that point. I was like, no, don't do it. Let's go for the win. But, you know, it's a chance you take. Personally, I would have went for the win instead of the points, but oh well. Anyway, start off the race. The track was real hot. Now, this changes stuff around here. The reason why Hamlin and Truex and some of these guys was so fast was their car handled so good in the center of the corner. They could just fly on the exit. And the track was hot, and that's what they was set up for. Remember, I was talking in the pick five contest. Kept saying they're gonna see a lot of guys qualify up front and trim, and then boom, go to the back, and that's what happened. Mainly the Chevrolets qualified great, but the race package was pretty horrible. And Jimmy Johnson got in the wall. I hate it for Jimmy. I know people still wants to see Jimmy win, and I want to see him get successful too, but he just ain't got it. Like I say, I think his days are over. I'd like to see him run one more 4 year as a farewell tour or something like that. I think that would be cool. But yeah, it's just my opinion on that. And with that being said, we did have a couple more accidents with Eric Almirola and Austin Dillon wrecking there, so we had some accidents. But anyway, Martin Truex started dead last and come, I think it's by lap six, he was 16th. So he had already passed half the field by six laps. And by the end of stage one, they made that call for no tires, which got him out front, and he went on ahead to win stage one and pick up a valuable bonus point. And playoff point, that is. And gained some more points in the standings. So that being said there, now Kyle Busch done the same thing in stage two. He got a little better push from Eric Jones, and that gave him the chance to get around to get that bonus point for the playoffs. See, everybody's right now searching for bonus points and playoff points. That's the key. Harvick, Truex, Busch, Chase Elliott, these guys, they're not caring right now about how much points they really get in certain areas. They're already locked in, and they just want to win a race. And that's where I kind of got confused with Truex and them, why they done that. Why didn't they pit when they had a chance? But anyway, my take on it, guys, I thought it was a good race just because you could pass. I know a lot of people, they made some improvements because a lot of these tracks like this now with the aero package, you just can't pass on them. And I think the heat had a lot to do with it. I think the hotter the track it is, the better racing you'll see. Slipping and sliding, but congratulations to Kevin Harvick and all you Harvick fans out there. He's starting to pick it up now. He's starting to get a little momentum. I think he can see Miami in the future. They're just starting to dial in. Denny Hamlin. I'm like Rusty. I think Denny's picking up. And Charlie NASCAR said the same thing. Whether you like Denny or not, he's starting to pick it up slowly. And I think he may be a factor. Bubba Wallace. I got to say something about Bubba Wallace here. I'm not trying to make anybody mad or nothing. I took up for the guy last week. I know he stood his ground last week and he said he wasn't going to get run over. But he's got to be told that you can't try to block or wreck everybody's trying to pass you. I know he got a good recognition this past week, and a lot of people patted him on the back. But come on, man. Whenever you're 5 miles an hour slower than the leaders, let him go. Don't block him. Don't try to wreck him. I mean, I think he hit by everybody out there except for the pace car today. My take on it, I just think he's trying too hard. He's in a bad car, And I don't know. He's losing a lot of respect to some of these drivers by not giving them a little bit of space whenever they're lapping him. I mean, I know it's frustration on his part. Richard Petty Motorsports ain't that good, so that's just my take on that. Anyway, let's get down to the finishing order here and talk about this. Now, Kevin Harvick wins the race. Denny Hamlin second. Kyle Larson, great run for him, third. I'm so happy for him and my buddy Thor Seth getting that run. My boy Martin Truex finishes fourth. We had a great points day. Daniel Suarez, top five. He needed that to stay in the hunt, and we'll talk about that in a minute. Kyle Busch finishes sixth, followed with Brian Priest finishes seventh. What a performance. Even though he got six by seven or eight people pitting for gas, you know, that's still a good run. William Byron, Chase Elliott, and Alex Bowman runs out your top ten. Ty Dillon almost got a top ten by finishing 11th. But let's go to the ones that really hurt yourself. Eric Jones finishing 18th. Kind of hurt him a little. Kurt Busch had a great car all day long. Finishes 23rd. Ryan Blaney, 24th. They run out of the gas with the last two laps there. And it just killed them. Ricky Spinhouse. I'm sorry, everybody calls him Spinhouse. Did spin out today. I mean, it was just a typical Ricky Spinhouse day. If Jack Roush keeps him, I'll never know why. Never know why. But that's just it. Ross Chastain, 29th. Eric Amarola, 33rd. Jimmy Johnson, 34th. That hurts his points. And Clint Bowyer, 37th. That is just a bad point day for him. We take a look here at the standings here. And, okay, here we go, guys, with the standings. Okay. Kyle Busch holds a 10-point gap over Joey Logano. Like I said, this is very important for these point standings. Huge because it counts. Kevin Harvick's third with 822. He's a little bit. Martin Truex, or Denny Hamlin's fourth with 815, and Martin Truex has got 805. That is, with three races to go, that is a tight race for third place. And it actually closes them all in. All the top five people still mathematically has a good shot of winning the championship for the regular season. So I really think they're all fighting for that. Brad Keselowski is six, but that's the cutoff line. The top five have a shot at the regular season championship. Everybody else is out. Chase Elliott, seventh. Kurt Busch, Ryan Blaney. Alex Bowman hanging in there, top 10. Eric Amarola knocked him back 11th, but he's fighting. William Byron, 12th. Kyle Larson, 13th. 624 points, which will knock Clint Bowyer's 599. So, three races left. Kyle Larson is not out. He's not, like, say, got to be happy about it. He's got to finish top 5, top 10 every week. Eric Jones, 623. That hurt him so bad. That puts him at a 24-point gap over Ryan Newman, 15th, and Clint Bowyer, 16th, who are tied. Now, these guys are tied for 16th with Clint Bowyer in there. Daniel Suarez, 17th. He's about 6-7 points out. And Jimmy Johnson fell to 18th and is like 11 points out of the 16th place. So, Jimmy took a big defeat, but it's not too horrible. So, it's going to come down to who can get lucky. These next three races, you've got to focus. Don't worry about the victories. If you're Jimmy Johnson, Ryan Newman, Eric Jones, don't worry about the wins. Make sure you finish top five. Get as much bonus points as you can get. That's the only thing that's going to get you through there. But, yeah. Thank goodness the cameraman's okay. He failed during the race there. Filming the race, that was horrible. But, yeah, I just want to say also a big shout-out to a buddy of mine who does Diecast Reviews, Diecast Buffet. I will put his link with the other ones down below here. Go check him out, Diecast Buffet. And he does a lot of good reviews on Diecast and stuff. And Pick 5 contest, I looked over. I didn't see anybody that got a winner this week. But I'm going to relook it. And you guys look at it yourself if you're in it. And just in case I make a mistake. But yeah, congratulations to Kevin Harvick and all you guys out there. Next week we're heading to Bristol, Tennessee. My home track. Can't wait to see the replay of it. So we got a big dirt track race here that night over here. If it rains, I'm probably going to come back home and watch a cup race. But we got a big dirt track race with the fire going on. I'm going to take my kid to it. So hate to do it because of Bristol, but, you know, kid kills hurt. Obviously, anybody's kids come first. So you gotta make sure they're having fun. You get to see a good dirt track race too. 50 lap modified race would be awesome. But yeah. You guys tell me what you think in the comments below of this race. And also, thanks to new subscribers out there. Congratulations to Righteous Redneck for hitting 800 subscribers. That is badass. Keep it up, buddy. And everybody else that's helped me out. General Goodrich winning the Fantasy League. He helps out so much with these videos and stuff, with giving us the weather and all that stuff. So congratulations goes out to him. And you guys have a good, remember, subscribe to the channel. Subscribe to everybody below. And next week, it's Bristol, baby.